you get stuck up with yourself, prayer becomes taking yourself to God. Prayer doesn't mean only you make known your voice to God, but prayer also means to hear the voice of God. Prayer is beyond making known your voice to God. Prayer is primarily hearing the voice of God and empowering your voice, guiding your voice, having heard His voice with the power and light of His voice, you handle the noise around you. That is the life, that is our call. But man gets stuck up with himself, his own noise, and he can't see things beyond. People who get stuck up, God calls them fool. You are a fool. Today you are suffering. Your life never reaches the shore because you are a fool. You are stuck up with yourself. What to make yourself happy? What should to watch? What should to eat? What should to drink? I should be happy. Who will make me happy? I call this man. I call that woman. I call this fellow to make me happy. Fool, don't you know the kingdom of God is within you? Don't you know the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords is in you? Do you know that you are, because He is? Many get stuck up with themselves and they die. In the gospel of today, that is in Luke's Gospel 12, we find a man coming and asking Jesus, 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 look, look, my brother is fighting with me for the property. Please, you come and share. Jesus didn't bother. He might have felt sad. After listening to the word of God, though there is fight between two brothers, own brothers, he got stuck up with what he lost. He got stuck up with the property which his brother is going to take more than his. He had no, even after listening to the word of God, he could not raise himself beyond the things of this earth. Beyond the things of this earth. The things that are today, tomorrow you will not be yours. Some get stuck up with themselves. Some get stuck up with their thoughts. Their, the things of the world make them mad. They look at somebody, oh, this lady is wearing nice pattu sari. My husband is also there. What he bought for me? Waste. Waste fellow. They compare themselves. What did he give me? What did he give me? They make themselves miserable and make everybody miserable. Instead of, thank God, we both worked. We built up our family. We brought up our children. Let's be grateful to God. Make our life a thanksgiving to Him. A danger will come. Many people get stuck up with their own thoughts, their own things of this earth. In today's, God has given us from the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 2, where we find the great man called, a wise man called King Solomon. At the end of the day of his life, he writes, vanity, everything is vanity. Life is running behind the wind and I am not able to catch. God said, stupid fellow, through my son David, I gave you the holy city of Jerusalem to build the holy temple for me, where you can worship the living God who made your father David a great king. He was a shepherd boy. By worshiping me, by loving me, by singing praises to me, receiving my power, defeating Goliath, defeating Saul, with me, he received life. With me, he became a great king. God spoke about David, a man close to my heart. And you are the son of that great king. And to build the temple you did not earn, my son David had prepared. Every piece of gold, silver, wood, stones, everything. And you went beyond yourself to see the human being. If any beautiful lady, you are running after her. And you want to marry her. And that lady brings her God. And comes and tells you, you are worshipping, I am not interfering. Why can't I worship my God? You had no guts to say that you belong to the living God. And there is no other God than yours. You did not say, we belong to the living God. Instead of bringing her to the living God, you got stuck up with her and with her beauty and with the things that she has brought. And you allowed to build a temple in Jerusalem. All the temples of this world, all the evil forces in the world have found place in Jerusalem, and you have corrupted the land Israel, corrupted the beautiful city called Jerusalem. So your own action has brought sin upon you. So your own children will be facing life. Your sin will affect your children. Everything is vanity, vanity, vanity. All that I thought will make me happy has made me sad. That's why in the book of Job, chapter 23, verse 10, Job says, amidst all the struggle, my Lord watches my steps. My Lord knows where I am going. Maybe my life is full of problems. My children are no more. My property is no more. Maybe my body is full of sores, but my Lord knows where I am going. The eyes of the Lord are always on me. That's enough for me. If my God allows me to do that, it's okay. If he has brought me to this, he will also bring me through it. If he has brought me to this problem, he will also be with me to move through that problem, to move out of that problem. That's why he could say, my Redeemer lives. And one day I will see him face to face. Yes. My dear friends, our life is, we can get stuck up with oneself, or we can get stuck up with the riches of this world, or to be always aware of the breath that has given us the breath.